On October 19th, I headed out to the Fonda to see JP Sachs perform his biggest headlining set ever, and it was down in Hollywood, so I got to see a little bit of the Walk of Fame as well, but I got there around 5:30 for the VIP experience. It was my first VIP experience since COVID and my first time experiencing what a socially distanced meet and greet was like. Honestly, I would save your money from here on out, but we did get to see this really cool roof deck, and I'll show you a little bit of the videos that I had meeting JP, but probably the coolest part of this experience was that he did play us a quick little acoustic set that was just for us that was really cool. I had written JP a letter like I do for all of the artists that I meet, but I wasn't allowed to actually physically hand it to him. I had to go hand it to Emily, who ran merch and meet and greet, and also JP has a song about her. She is the absolute sweetest person, but that was a little strange.
For me.
Thank you for prioritizing hygiene.
You're welcome.
Okay, so I'm gonna play a little medley of some of the songs I couldn't fit in the set. Well, okay, so if we play all of the songs I want to play, the set's like 2.5 hours, which is too, it's, they kicked us out. So I had to.
They can't kick us all.
They can. So because y'all clearly care the most, I will make sure y'all, if there's any song that isn't in the set that you really wanted to hear, hopefully we can just make it happen right now. Is out of my control as anything has ever been. I'm uncomfortable, but lately I've been kind of fucking into it. The way you wrap yourself around my body, I think I could live in it. I could live in it. You're not like anything I know or I've known. Like anything I know or I've known. You're not like anything I know or I've known. Like anything I know or I've known. You scare me. But I'm not afraid of it. You make me nervous, but I want to stay in it. I tend to complicate, find fancy ways to say I just want more of you. I just want more of you. Watched a TED talk on heartbreak. He had a smart person accent. He said, don't look through the photos. Then I looked through my photos. He came to Portugal in 2014 just to spend a couple days with me. You flew halfway around the world for me. Now we can't even be in the same. My friends are making sure I don't see. I strategize a path to the bathroom so I don't oppress you. You leave before the concert is finished. It's probably for the best that you did it. Make us try to fake our way through. Hey, how are you? We can't even be in the same. Still feel like cheap because of me, they do. Do you feel that too? We can't even be in the same. My friends are making sure I don't see. I strategize a path to the back. probably for the concert is finished. It's probably for the best that you did. Make us try to fake our way through. Hey, how are you? We can't even be in the same. But I'm not afraid of you. You make me nervous, but I wanna stay. I tend to complicate, find fancy ways to say I just want more of you. I just want more of you. I'm putting out a deluxe edition of the album in like 3 weeks. It has 3 new songs on it, and one of the new songs I'm going to play on stage, and another one I'm going to play right now. Okay, the choices are a complicated love song, trying to love yourself and somebody else at the same time, and then the other one is how would you describe Love V Logic? It's like, the other one is, you know, trying to get over someone, but doing a bad job of it.
I like
the
first
one. Said,
first one.
It's a song called Hold On To Me. Technically, the Love V Logic I have played before, and it's like, is findable on the internet. This one is not. So this is a more unique, special moment we can have right here that wouldn't be available anywhere else. I didn't used to have expensive taste. You didn't used to have an up until 3 a.m. habit. I didn't used to want to share a place. You didn't used to have a subtle Canadian accent. Picking up on all your reasons. Your funny taste in television. This perfect story we've been spinning. I love it, but I lose me in it. Baby, I wanna let you hold on.
Are you sound check?
Oh, Julia co-wrote on that song, that's why they're playing it.
Put together, none of my shit showing, and I wanted anything that was hard for me to deal with, I wanted to deal with by myself, because if I loved someone, why would I want to give them something hard to deal with? It turns out, that's less about love and more about just being afraid to trust somebody enough, and I'm trying to learn that it's actually more loving to let somebody see the parts of you that you're afraid of, and then be there with you in them. Work in progress figuring that out.
in practice, but in a song, I got one.
Yeah.
It's called Hold It Together.
But in every girl's eyes, I just find some more peace. Love don't get better. It's just an argument. Don't ounce the truth in it. I wanna believe you, but you can't. I'm so articulate. I've tried walking away in my head. For a moment it's peaceful, but it scares me to death. So I guess.
You. Last time, everyone.
When the whole world was ending, you come over, right? You come over and you stay the night. Would you love me before another day? All our fears would be irrelevant. If the world was ending, you come over, right? So I'd be falling while I hold you right.
So that pretty much sums up the night. My friend and I got to meet Amy Allen at the merch table, which was so cool because if you read my music blog, you know I absolutely love her music. But then we just got in a Lyft and went home, and it was super, super easy this time around. We had a great time at the show, and it was amazing that Julia came out to play If the World Was Ending with JP, considering Julia is one of the big reasons that now I love going to shows so much. Her show was the first GA show I ever went to, so that'll always have like a special memory place in my heart. So I hope you enjoyed the vlog. If you enjoyed it, please give it a like, hit subscribe, comment down below, you know, all the things. And I will be back with my reaction to Gracie Abrams' debut album on Friday. So I will see you then. Have a great day and goodbye.